Hey guys, I'm Robert. Today I'm bringing you one more video on Superwhisper, a powerful dictation app that not only transcribes with great accuracy, but also can process what you dictate with AI. One of its most powerful features is context awareness. And once you understand how this works, it can open up a lot of possibilities for your workflow. I've noticed that a lot of users hit a wall with this when they are just getting started. They come in excited after seeing videos or demos of the app online, but when they try this out, well, this is one of those things that seem not to be working quite right. So I would like to help you guys not only by explaining how to set this up, but also I will share some tips and undocumented hacks that I have discovered through a lot of testing. Now, real quick, if this is your first time around here, Superwhisper lets you do stuff that goes way beyond basic transcription. Do you want to format text for emails or messages? Do you need to generate content with AI, writing outlines, summarizing, extracting insights, coding? All of this and more is possible. And something that makes this even more convenient is the ability to create multiple modes, each with their own set of AI instructions. I have tested a lot of AI-powered voice-to-text apps, and I can tell you that context awareness, what I want to focus in this video, is not something unique to Superwhisper, but its implementation, in my opinion, is way ahead of the others. This is what expands the capabilities of the app beyond dictation alone, since you can now provide information or text together with what you speak, and AI will use this during the processing stage. Things you can do with context, for example, is to select something and say, "Please simplify the selected text because it's a bit hard for me to understand and I need it in more common everyday language." Superwhisper can understand and process my request. Another thing I can do, even without selecting anything, is that I can say, "Hey, I plan to write a short article on this, so please give me a quick outline that I can use as a guide. I just have to wait a moment," and there we go. Let me go to the settings of Superwhisper. Something that many users seem to miss is that most of the built-in modes do not have context awareness. Only Super mode has this active by default. Now, yes, all of these modes are great and very useful, but they are mostly for basic transcription with some formatting. So even though you got a very powerful context awareness in Super mode, you are limited to a specific type of use. Having it in here is useful. For example, if you want Superwhisper to get the correct spelling of names and vocabulary in your active window, or if you want to select text and ask for it to format the content in bullet points, fix punctuation, or convert everything in uppercase. For this kind of stuff, it's okay. But if you got some tasks that require content generation or more reasoning, well, very soon you will find that this is not for that. If you want absolute control, you will need to create a custom mode. And by the way, you can always rename your modes by clicking up here. And then you can go to the change prompt section and activate those features that I've been talking about. One thing to keep in mind is that context awareness is not always necessary. And specifically, the application context toggle should only be activated if you know that you really need it. That is because if you are using it for everything, well, you may end up sending unnecessary information to AI, which could affect the quality of the results. If, for example, you plan to create a mode to translate only what you speak, then better leave this off. Because if you're in a note with lots of text and you dictate something, well, AI will be receiving all of that additional content, which can create confusion, and it may choose to translate that instead. Of course, a lot of this will also depend on the actual prompt that you give to your mode. But what I want to say is that as much as possible, you should use these toggles intentionally. If you got the Alfred workflow that I made for Superwhisper, turning on application context can allow you to have a back and forth interaction with AI. That is because I included a snippet, this one here, that allows you to quickly insert both your dictation and the result. For example, "Hey, please write me a short haiku." Now I see my result in my recording window. So by using the snippet for Alfred, I got my question and my result in there. And now I can ask, That's great, but can you explain it to me? Since app context is enabled for this mode I'm using, AI is receiving all the text from up here, so it can understand that this is a conversation we're holding. And if I want, I can continue with more. I insert the snippet again and say, that's beautiful, make another one. There's a way to automate the entire thing, by the way, but that's beyond the scope of what I wanted to cover here. Before I go any further, let me explain something else. There are three types of context that Superwhisper can work with. First, we have application context, which is what I just showed you. It doesn't take screenshots. It doesn't capture all the content from all the apps that you have open. Don't worry. It simply uses the accessibility API to know what is in your active window. It grabs vocabulary, names, the name of the app that you are in, and if you have your cursor inside an active input field like a note, it will grab all the text from there as well. The second type is clipboard context, and the third type is selected text context. As I was telling you, Super Mode has all three active, but here that we are on a custom mode, well, we only got two toggles. I think at some point in the future, we might see a third toggle for selected text. But for now, if you want to activate this, you have to do it manually directly on your mode's configuration file. It's super simple, and I'm sure you can get it even if you're a basic user, don't worry. You just have to go to Super Whispers folder. By default, this is inside your documents folder. Then you go inside your modes folder and you look for the specific mode you need. You can quick look these files and look for the name field. That way you will know which mode you will be editing. If you have the Alfred workflow for Superwhisper, I've integrated a way to see all your modes, and by running an Alfred action, you can reveal this in Finder. This is useful in case you have a lot of modes like me. I think I got about 20 modes, so this gives you a faster way to get to the one file unit. Once in there, you just need to open this in your preferred text editor and change the context from selection from false to true. Save this file and restart Superwhisper for the changes to take place. Your custom modes will now be able to grab any text you have selected. By now, you may already start to understand a bit better the potential with these context awareness features, but I still want to show you one more important detail. There's three different steps going on here. First, we got the dictation process where the recording happens. Then there's a transcription process where your voice is being transformed into text. And finally, we also got this step where your transcribed voice together with your prompt and any additional context gathered is sent to AI for processing. Here's what you have to know. The selected text context is captured exactly at the moment that you start your dictation, whenever you press your keyboard shortcut for the first time. This means that you can have selected text when you start recording and then move around somewhere else without having to worry about it anymore because it has already been captured. Your clipboard context can be captured either within 3 seconds before you start your recording or anytime while dictating. I find it much more easier to copy here. There's no rush that way. When you press your shortcut to stop recording, which will happen here, it's at that moment that the last thing you copied in this period will be captured. Finally, application context will be captured not during dictation or transcription, but the moment that transcription finishes and everything is sent to AI for processing, exactly in this spot. You have to watch out for that because sometimes the transcription process, depending on the length of your dictation, will take some time. So if you move to a different window or do something else, it may actually capture the information from the wrong place and not what you need. Now that you know this, you can do so much. For example, let's say that I have 3 different sources of text. One is a website with some information about the meaning of colors. One is a note where I have a markdown table example, and another one is a note where I have some text in Spanish. I can select my markdown table and dictate something like this. Please look at the format of my selected text. I want you to use content from my clipboard context to give that same format. Make it concise, and by the way, I need it in the same language that you find in the application context. As you saw, I went and copied content from the website in the middle of my dictation and made sure that I was back on my window when I finished the recording. With this kind of workflow, you can grab text from different sources and use commands or contents from your own dictation, and everything is combined into one very powerful request. As you can see, there's my markdown table with the content I copied all in Spanish. Something very useful to learn is how to reference these separate pieces of content for specific instructions. I recently did some contributions to the documentation of Superwhisper, and you can find specifically about this I'm telling you under custom mode in the section about prompting tips. One more thing that I wanted to cover here is how to capture context in case you need to reprocess a previous dictation. The thing is that Superwhisper is great, but nothing is perfect. Sometimes the app might have an issue, or there could be problems with the AI servers, the cloud models, internet could fail. There's so many things that could throw an error. But don't worry, if that happens, you have not lost your dictation. Superwhisper has a pretty good backup system. Even if you don't get the expected result, you will still have the recording that you can reprocess. Just go to the history, right-click on the sidebar, and select process again. But the thing is that when reprocessing a previous dictation, I have always wanted to send the same kind of context we have discussed in this video. There's no obvious way to do that within the app's interface, but after a lot of testing, I discovered a solution that has saved me a few times. So let me share this with you. This is a tiny bit more advanced, but stay with me. First of all, instead of reprocessing your dictation in the history tab as usual, the solution is to have a script that opens the file in Superwhisper. I will share the script that I wrote for this in the video description, and you can use it as it is, or you can create your own version. The script simply looks through the recordings folder, it grabs the most recent dictation file, and it opens it with Superwhisper. You can run this with Better Touch Tool, a macro on Keyboard Maestro, or with other automation apps. I personally like to run it with Kando. The important thing is to be able to run it while being in the active window that you want to capture application context from. That way, this will still work because remember that this type of context is captured between the transcription and the AI processing steps. For selected text and clipboard context, I found that if you start a dictation with selected text, or if you copy something while dictating and then cancel that dictation by pressing escape, both context types get stored in sort of an invisible buffer. From there, you can switch to the window that you want for app context and run the script that I told you before. This lets you capture all three types of context without having to dictate anything. Of course, you don't have to go for all of this complexity, but it's there as a possibility. And believe me, sometimes it can be super useful. This is not documented, and it might even be a bug, but I see it as a hidden extra feature enabling some advanced workflows. I hope everything I have covered here helps you get more out of this amazing tool. If you have questions, drop them in the comments, or you can simply join the Discord server to get help from the community. If you are thinking about getting Superwhisper, I would really appreciate it if you use my affiliate link in the description. It doesn't cost you anything extra, but it helps support the time and effort that I put into creating videos like this one. Your support motivates me to keep sharing more content like this. Don't forget to sign up to my newsletter for more updates on what I'm up to. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next one.